Shrink Wrap.
Hi guys, this is Marilyn. Today, I would like to introduce you all to a very special client. So let's bring her in, shall we? Come on up!
Yay!
Hey Rebin, welcome to the show. You look great today. Say hello to the camera.
Yay! Hello!
So in today's episode, let's talk about designing a pet logo, right? High five on that, yay! So why create one for your pet? Well, why not? Because it's fun and you get to design something for your loved one. In a world full of competitive furry faces, creating a pet logo helps to create a unique identity for your pet. Also, it opens up the opportunity for your pet to become a brand. Before starting your pet logo, think about what and where you will be using it for. So let's now talk about the pet logo I did for Red Bean. So how did I get started on the design? First things first, think about the idea of the logo. What is it about your pet that is uniquely them? It could be how they look, how they behave, or what specific characteristics that you would like to feature in the logo. For Red Bean's logo, I wanted to feature specifically on her cuteness. Also, think about if you'd like to have it as a logo mark, a word mark, or a combination mark. Now that you have your idea, gather inspirations and styles of references. The way I did this was to do it through Pinterest. Think about the stylistic execution that you'd like to have for the logo. Is it something soft and pastel, bold and iconic, or minimalistic? The process I took was to first sketch up what the shape and form could look like based on the stylistic reference that I have. And then once I'm happy with the overall shape, it's time to work it up on Illustrator. And here it is. I decided to go with a bold illustration style because it captured her cuteness well. And it helps to make the overall logo stand out really well on a small scale, making it really versatile for applications. Also, from the very beginning, I knew that I had the stylistic reference of the Sanrio characters in mind because they're very memorable, they're very iconic, but also it fits well to highlight her cute character. As for the choice of typography to complement the logo mark, I used a type of cursive font because it makes it look really lighthearted overall, and it also fits well with her cute personality. So Red Bean, were you happy with the logo that I designed for you?
It's too powered up!
So how was the logo used in the end? Well, as you can see here, I used it on her dog tag. And it also lives in her social media account, and even the cookie cutter that was used to make cookies for her birthday party. And my future plan is to create pet products like these. So I hope this video inspires you to create a logo for your pet. If you love designing, this project will be a great one to work on, especially for a client that you love and care for. Comment below if you have done a logo for your pet. We would love to see it. And also, if you have any questions, put them in the comments below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit that bell to stay up to date with the latest shrink wrap videos. Thanks for watching, and until then, see you guys next time! K.O.